Finally, tonight, we take a look at the campaign for the House of Representatives. Few contests are being watched as closely as the fight for a new congressional seat in Battleground, Nevada. It's a seat both parties would dearly love to win. But as Mitch Fox of Vegas PBS reports, there are no safe bets. His story is part of our new collaboration with public media partners across the country as we bring you reports from areas that will likely determine the outcome of the election in a series we call Battleground Dispatches.
During the last decade, Nevada was the fastest growing state in the nation and picked up an additional seat in Congress. Democrats enjoy a 13.5% voter registration advantage in that new district. But before you bet the well-funded Democratic candidate here is a shoe-in, remember the old adage, all politics is local.
The complexities of this race read like a novel. There's big money, aggressive attacks, a famous family name, even a potential bankruptcy looming. And it's all playing out in a district that covers half the state.
Democratic State Senator Steven Horsford is having the fight of his life, down in every poll, sometimes by double digits, because of this man, Republican Danny Tarkanian, the son of legendary UNLV basketball coach Jerry Tarkanian. Horsford has been appealing to the 55% of voters registered as Democrats to win this sprawling and increasingly diverse district. From its sparsely populated mining communities to the densely populated Latino and African American neighborhoods in the northern tip of the Las Vegas Valley. Both candidates are spending a lot of time on the road to meet with voters. Horsford is currently the majority leader of the state Senate and has focused his campaign on economic issues.
What I've heard from the voters is the same thing. What are we going to do to get people working and grow the economy? How are we going to address the housing crisis, and what are you going to do to protect Medicare and Social Security? I have strong positions on those issues. My opponent does not.
Tarkanian has benefited from his family's well-known name here, but failed to win an election in three prior attempts at public office. He has his own take on this race.
I've tried very hard to get out to all the different areas within the communities. I've had business meetings. I've had meetings with business leaders in the African American community, talking about businesses that are there and how we can help them get started and expand. At the same time, I've been out in Yerington talking to the onion farmers and some of the ranchers about issues that they're dealing with workers and so forth. So I've tried very hard to be a good representative and get a good understanding of what's important for those constituents.
In August, the campaign was infused with racial tension when Tarkanian seemed to suggest that Horsford was relying on his own ethnicity to win support from African American voters. While defending himself in front of a gathering of Republicans, Tarkanian said he could, quote, be like Steven Horsford, who's not doing anything with that community, and pretend we're black, end quote. Tarkanian apologized and ended up picking up the support of the local NAACP president. Patricia Cunningham is a local talk radio host.
The Tarkanian name is one of the most recognizable names in the history of collegiate basketball. Not only is it a recognizable name, it is a name that African-American athletes and their families have embraced because his father reached out to African-American athletes when no other Division I program or few Division I programs were willing to open the door.
Despite the benefit of name recognition, Tarkanian is facing growing legal and financial problems that have complicated his campaign and opened him up to criticism. He and his family were recently hit with a $17 million judgment by the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, or FDIC, because of a failed land deal.
The FDIC is moving to seize his assets, perhaps his house.
Steve Sebelius is a columnist for the Las Vegas Review-Journal.
When there is no legal or tactical reason that any reasonable person would not have already filed for bankruptcy unless they're running for office and they're afraid of a flyer or a TV ad that says he's actually running for bankruptcy. I believe, win or lose, he's going to have to file. And that presents certain problems. I mean, here Danny Tarkanian will be involved in litigation against the very government that he now is going to be representing, assuming he wins.
Early voting trends are favoring Democrats in Nevada. And for Horsford's part, he is hoping President Obama will win the battleground state and help sweep his congressional campaign to victory as well. But the race has made Democrats nervous. Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid has blasted Tarkanian for the bad land deal. And super PACs are helping to bolster Tarkanian's campaign by inundating the airwaves with blistering attack ads aimed at Horsford. It's one race, but it matters to the bigger picture as Democrats look to Nevada's 4th District as one of the 25 net seats they need to win back the House. In the end, Tarkanian is depending on rural voters who tend to be Republican and turn out to vote in greater numbers than the Democrats. Horsford is relying on the Democratic machine developed by Senator Reid in Nevada and a voter registration advantage to squeak past his opponent in one of the most closely watched congressional races in the nation.
Our next battleground dispatch will come from Iowa, where the issue of immigration is bubbling to the surface.